THEO Papodoulakis, espero haberlo pronunciado correctamente, de Indigo View Productions. Estudió producción y dirección de cine en Inglaterra, cofundador y director artístico de Indigo View Productions en Creta. Ha dirigido varios cortometrajes con varios premios, tres series de televisión, numerosos comerciales, documentales, vídeos musicales y vídeos promocionales turísticos. Vamos a darle la bienvenida. Bienvenido. Muchísimas gracias por estar en el día de hoy con nosotros aquí en Landi Madrid y adelante.
I guess she said, welcome to Madrid, and have a very nice time. I'm a director. I'm also a producer and a co-founder of the company Indigo View, based in the island of Crete in Greece. We've been producing commercials, tourist commercials, for the past 15 years. It might be a little bit more than that, actually. And my company is mainly focusing on the production of TV series and films. Our main focus is to produce feature films and TV series for international markets. And for a living, we also do tourist commercials, which is a lot of fun. Basically, one of the main activities of the commercial side of my company is producing tourism commercials. To be honest with you, I've learned a lot through this. When we began producing tourism commercials in Greece, most of the commercials that were produced back then, was the glossy type. Beautiful couples running on the beach and beautiful aerial shots with nice epic music, those types of commercials. And with our background as storytellers and with experience that we had with working with on scripts and script development and working with actors, helped us to actually bring this knowledge into making commercials with a storyline. To be honest with you, I get very bored when I have an order to make commercials based on beauty shots and beautiful people smiling and beautiful aerial and scenery shots. What I do, actually, I've actually worked on, because I'm also a producer, and most of the times I also go to the clients and I pitch the projects. I try to become friends with the mayors and the people that work in the marketing sections of this company, because I always believe deep inside that I'm going to persuade them that they have to go and make a story. And believe me, that has worked. I have to charm them in the beginning, I have to agree a lot with them, and then I proceed and I say, listen, your idea is very nice, you know, we can film the scenery and etc., but you know, how about this story? And sometimes I have a story in my mind, it works a lot, that I've actually thought of it. And sometimes these stories just pop up whilst I'm driving there on my motorbike. I just come up with a story in my head, you know, and I present it. As simple as that. You know, that is crazy. It stresses out some people. It stresses out my producers. Sometimes my producers, my co-producers, believe that I'm going to be pitching what is there on paper, and suddenly I just do a turnaround and I pitch something else. What I do, I'm very spontaneous. I try to avoid stereotypes. A lot of us and the majority of people feel very comfortable within stereotypes. They like living in a comfort zone. I think that life becomes more entertaining when you start breaking these stereotypes. when you start surprising people, and when you add a little of comedy in the recipe, as you've realized, I think things are much more simple as we think it is, especially when it comes down to writing scripts. Because writing a script, there's a standard remedy for me. It's basically, first of all, be as much truthful as you can. And being truthful is just basically looking around you. Let's say that you're sitting in a table with people you don't know very much, and you're sitting there and everybody's truly thinking of, okay, what can I say to somebody else to crack a joke so we start getting a little bit warm here? And you know, that I think the majority of people, that is what they think when they're sitting in a group of people they don't know. Whoever cracks a nice joke, then people start like lighting up and feeling a little bit more comfortable, yeah? So pretty much these are small things that I observe as a director, and I like doing that, and things that I like bringing into my work. I will actually, I like to speak into speak with examples. I will, our first, let's say, major campaign that we've done for the island of Crete, which the island of Crete is the biggest island of Greece, was a campaign based on the slogan "Incredible Crete," and we, the mayor of the island trusted us, and we came up with a few ideas with storylines. And I also explained to them that I what is there on paper is just there on paper, but they have to allow me freedom to actually do something to ideas, work with my actors and come up with ideas the last minute. So basically what's there in the script is not necessarily what they will see at the end. The end product won't exactly be there, what they read on the script, and they were kind of fine with it. But as you actually said before, you have to trust the filmmakers, wouldn't you? And because I'm me as a producer, what I actually look for directors when they come and they're interviewed at our company is to actually see that they're confident enough as storytellers. And I really love to actually trust them, even if they're going to change the idea the last minute. So basically, the municipality of Crete asked me to produce one commercial about the beaches of the island, the other one about the history, because we have the oldest, the most ancient history of Europe on Crete, the Minoan civilization, which is a video that I'll show to you. The other one was the food, which a lot of people know the Cretan Mediterranean diet. And the other one, I don't remember right now. So those were the four videos that we had to present to them. And we did present it to them. So one of those is the history about the Minoan civilization, which we can actually watch.
Civilization was the first advanced civilization of Europe. Palace of Knossos that we visited used to be the center of the Minoan civilization because it is the largest palace and the most glorious one.
Hey,
So we presented these videos, and the municipality was very excited. They liked the work, the quality of the work, and we were very happy. And on the telephone with the chief of the tourism tourism marketing of the island, he says that, listen, something popped up today, and he said, we haven't touched on one of the most important elements of the island. And I says, what is that? And he says, hospitality, you know. And the truth is that Cretans are generally very friendly people. You won't be surprised when you come to our island, let's say if you're working in a village and you're walking outside a house, for example, people will have a look at you, they'll say, hey, come in, you know, and you might end up, you know, sitting and eating with them, eating with a family you haven't never seen in your life. So this is something that generally happens on the island. So they said, okay, hospitality is a very important thing, maybe the most important thing, and, you know, we need another commercial. And I said, on the phone, I said, I have a great idea. I have a very good idea. He says, so what is that? I says, whatever it is, we should definitely go and film it. And I can film it for you in the next 2 days. I've got the actors ready for you. I've got the story. I said, go ahead, pitch it on the phone, yeah? He says, okay, so this idea is this and this and that. And you'll actually see it. I'll show this commercial to you. And then I say, well, that's kind of risky. That's a nice idea, but it's kind of risky because you'll realize why. I said, yeah, it's risky, but you have to trust me. You have to really trust me on this because, first of all, this is a thought that I had whilst I was filming somewhere 2 days ago. And whilst I was in a road full of orange trees left and right on the road, I was eating these oranges. And I was joking around to my friends and my co-workers that just imagine somebody walks out the orange grove and he sees me eating all these oranges, you know, what would happen? So this was a joke that cracked around at the film shoot that day. So I brought in this example to pitching them the script that you'll watch right now.
Έχουμε μουσαφυρέους.
Καλώς.
Πάμε.
Καλώς όρισες.
Hello. Σαν. Ορέστη. Γρηγόρη. Γεια σου. Άντε, γεια μας.
Thank you, Gregory.
So the protagonist over there is an Englishman that lives in Crete, and he's the art director on my projects, and he's also an actor. The other actor is a friend of mine. He's an actor that is played in a TV series that I've done. And the family that you saw there is people that live at that house, true people that live in that neighborhood. I think we literally set up this production within 2 days, and we went and filmed it. This is the most successful video that we've done in the history of Greek tourism commercials in Greece. It has millions of hits all around the world. I was surprised. I didn't know that this is going to take place. You know, it went viral within 2 or 3 days. People really liked it. They thought it was something very different to what they've used to seeing in terms of the touristic videos. And in terms of what it represents for Crete, is that Cretan people have harsh characteristics. Sometimes you can't tell if they're friendly or not. So that comes across with the guy wearing the black clothes. That was the clever element of the film, that becomes harsh in the beginning. And the story transforms as it goes. Also watching it right now, I was also noticing that it's one of the videos that hasn't got music in the beginning for the first 1 minute, which is really nice. Most of the tourism videos that are made today are bombarded with music, and especially the epic kind of music that goes on in most of the videos. If I was going to advise a new filmmaker what to do with the music in his commercial, is to tell him to not think music in the beginning, because I think that audiences are kind of fed up with all this kind of similar music that is playing on videos. For me, going back to the main theme of my talk is about allowing freedom to the directors, and I feel very lucky as a filmmaker living on an island and in a country that they trust me as a filmmaker, which means that I can actually experiment. I can feel very free when I'm going to shoot, or what I can change. Of course, I'm working in financial boundaries, in a budget, and I try to keep within the budget. When I have to film a commercial in 2 days, I have to make it happen in 2 days. But what I usually do is I do experiment with the story. Sometimes when I get very bored, I even change the dialogues. If there's two actors playing, and I think that the story has become very boxed, I will actually tell them, just swap your dialogues and see what happens over here. Maybe something more interesting arises. I try all different like experimentations like that. I try to keep my mind very clear when I'm on the film set. Because when I'm rehearsing with my actors, I like to keep everything fresh and try and improvise as much as I can, because I'm sure that sometimes the stuff that is improvised or something that happens on the set, which is not programmed, is something that feels and looks more real. So this is stuff that I continuously do. Obviously, I've got a very well-trained crew that works near me, because this stresses out the crews generally when there's last-minute changes to plans, or sometimes when we're going to film inside a house, you know, I say, no, I don't want to film inside the house because the sun and the sky is beautiful. I want to film it inside, and the art director might be decorating the house for the last 2 days. But I have people that are working next to me that they kind of know the way I work. And so I feel this comfort doing my thing. As much as storytelling is concerned, I'm working on two major campaigns. The other one is one for the new campaign for Crete, and the other one is for Attica, one of the biggest prefectures of Greece. Yesterday we had the deadline for giving in the final scripts. And believe me, I've been changing the scripts yesterday, and today when I woke up in the morning, I thought, they are terrible, I have to change them again. And so we've actually handed this in because I'm trying to work in within a time frame of here with them. But I feel that I have to go to Athens and talk to these people and explain to them this theory that I've been telling you about, and that they have to allow me this freedom, the storytelling freedom, in order for this campaign to be fresh and new. Obviously, what I do is I do select ideas. I do select ideas. Your campaign was tremendous. I really love it. And for the reason that you had a very small crew and that it seems very low budget, which is which we also work on very low budgets generally. What you just saw, for example, that was made on a budget of 10,000 euros, the last commercial that you saw. And the new ones that I'm going to do is about double or triple the budget, but yet, according to what is there for me to do, they're very low budget. So basically, the way I tackle the budget is to keep my film crew small. But what is very, very important is the story. And basically, your story has all the elements over there to work with a small crew. What I do is I think it's very important for me and also the people that I work with is to have an open view to watching other stuff, movies, documentaries, and especially commercials. I gather ideas. And one commercial, I remember we had this script and we were ready to film in 2 or 3 days in Crete for the prefecture of Sitia. Because I was busy, I think, filming a TV series, I was brought into the project like 2 days and they said, okay, this is the script. And I read it and I said, oh, this is terrible, I don't like it. And I was like, okay, I have to do something about this. So I said, okay, give me 2 hours and I'll be back with something new. And sometimes it really helps me to work in time frames. Sometimes I really push myself. I said, okay, whatever you do right now, I don't know, go to a museum, open the internet, just scan through videos, but whatever kind of idea pops up in 1 hour, that will be that. You know, and then I'll work on that idea. So I saw this American commercial. I'm not so sure. I think it was about a bank. And it was this guy that was somewhere in the Bahamas. And he was on a boat. And it was the end of his holiday. And he was leaving this island. And he was on this boat. And he was crying. And he was waving back at the people that were working on this at this hotel on the beach side, and he was crying on the boat and was saying, "Oh, goodbye." And all the people that were working at the hotel were feeling the secret happiness that this guy was leaving. So that's such a good idea. So I start developing this in my mind. So after, I think, 2 hours, I exit my office and I said, I have a good idea, okay? So the idea is this and that, and you'll watch this commercial right now. And it's about this couple and this man doesn't want to leave Satya because he had a brilliant time, okay? And my co-producers, and one of them is here, Joanna Davis, she's produced all the stuff that you will see today. Said you must be nuts. The client isn't an easy client. You know, you have to talk to him. So I get on the phone. He's the mayor of Sitia, and he says, "Listen, you know, I just came up with this brilliant idea. Okay, and the idea is this and that and that and that." And the guy says, "Yeah, but what about all the other stuff that we've been talking about for some months now?" So that was great stuff, but this one, I just got a gut feeling that it's going to do really well.
Thank you.
Again, that was inspiration that I had watching another commercial. Okay, we have to admit that it's very hard to create something totally new. So we are very lucky with the internet right now. You know, you can spend, let's say, 1 hour just researching through videos that have been done before. You know, you can come up with another idea that is not so similar to the one you've seen before, and you can come up with something nice. This commercial done very, very well, you know, and the thing is that the THEO had never done anything to promote their prefecture before. So the clients wasn't so sure even about this commercial. When they saw it, they were a bit terrified. But what I made sure is that we had a second crew, and that second crew was filming all the beautiful scenery, the beaches and the places of the island. So we edited another, I don't know, 2 minute video, which came as a package with this video. And so the clients, first of all, when the clients saw this video, they were saying, what is this music? This is Europe, you know, no, this is Satya, you can't have this music. And I was like on the phone with them, no, you shouldn't change this music. You know, it gives this character, you know, it makes the video funny, etc. So they weren't so sure, you know, but I was very lucky because the people that were working the publicity office of Satya, they were young people, so they really trusted the work. And they sent us the results of actually what they've done with a new website with a lot of paid social media money that they put into promoting this video to the rest of Europe. And they had a tremendous increase of tourism the next year. And I was talking, it was the percentage was something like about 50% of, they had an increase of tourists visiting Satya. So we were very happy about that. Basically, I have a workshop tomorrow, and I'm going to be talking in more detail about some of the practicals and some of the details that we put into and how we work with people in our office in creating concepts. Generally, what I would like to talk about is the creative work that takes place, and how I try to inspire the people that write scripts in my office and to think differently and come up with new and fresh ideas. I truly believe about tourism spots is that the audience doesn't have time to actually register all the scenery that we're actually showing to them. You know, all the cities of the world, believe me, they are beautiful, and they all have very beautiful landscapes and scenery, you know. But the thing is that, first of all, and this is my personal approach, I think that the video works as a reminder of the name. So a video and a nice idea with a nice character just reminds the audience that's a place out there called Sitia, which I've never heard about. So let's Google it. Okay, so I truly believe that, you know, especially nowadays, which audiences are bombarded with images and beautiful landscapes, you can just have two people talking to each other, or just one person talking to him in front of a mirror, you know, and saying something interesting and funny and real that the audience could relate to, and they can come up with a name, and from there you actually want to deliver your audiences to the website or to Google the place. And I think that videos, that is the main purpose of tourism videos, to actually make the audience actually go remember the name of the place and go and Google it up. Because I think that all the rest is there in the websites. Unfortunately, in Greece, we create, people like our work, so they call us very often to create tourism videos for them. And I go and, okay, we come up with all these nice ideas, and we're not a full-pack creative agency. We don't actually work on their websites. We don't do this kind of work. But sometimes I'll see that their website, for example, is non-existent, or they haven't refreshed it for the past, I don't know, 20 years. So I'm coming up with a storyline or a wacky theme, you know, and then I look at their website and it's like crap. And I'm like, sometimes I'm honest with them. I says, listen, you know, just delay me, just leave it, we won't do it now for you. Just fix your website first, you know, just tidy this up, come up with a theme, and then I will come in as a creative agency that we mostly write video ideas. That's it. I think half an hour has flown by. Any questions? Was that half an hour? Sorry.
Un fuerte aplauso. Vamos a pasar a la ronda de preguntas. No sé si hay alguna pregunta para esta excelente, como todas las que vimos esta mañana, ponencia, antes de empezar con la proyección. Vamos a ver si hay alguna pregunta. Todo muy claro, una ponencia, desde luego, muy interesante. Sí, tenemos para aquí una pregunta.
One, two.
Okay. Ahora sí.
Theo, you're working in Crete. Now you're working in Attica, so you try to expand from Crete into whole Greece, or?
Generally, my company works all over Greece.
Okay,
and
it does.
We also work overseas as well. So
okay.
we consider ourselves as a very active European company. But in terms of tourism, we've mainly done work for Crete.
Okay.
Now Attica once, also Greece approached us to make them some tourist campaigns. It's nice, you know. I think that we have to move away from Crete for a while, you know, and produce something in the rest of Greece, you know.
Okay. You said you're working also for television. Can you just give a little sum up what you're doing in series?
Yeah, well, right now we're developing a period drama, which is called Imaret. It's about the Turkish-Greek war back in the 18th century. We've also produced about 8 years ago a record-breaking TV series in terms of audience ratings in the history of Greek television. It was called The Island, based on the book of Victoria Hislop called The Island. And this TV series was sold to about 12 European countries. This was also a period piece. It was taking place in the 1950s and was about a leprosy colony just opposite Crete. And this was a great success for us. We're also shooting a feature film next November, and based on the very popular book of Nikos Kazatzakis called Christ Recrucified. This is taking place in today. The story, so we're doing all these projects, you know, I'm involved in a lot of things. Sometimes sometimes I need to direct something, a tourism video, to, you know, because when I'm really involved in developing scripts or, you know, shooting a drama, TV drama, coming back to do something like this is real fun. When I work, you know, in this environment, I try for all my crew to have a very fun experience. I won't hide that sometimes, you know, I purposely film a lot next to beaches so we can swim in our breaks and we can have a nice meal in a taverna. You know, I have this mentality of, you know, having fun at work and having smiley people working next to me. So, yeah, tourism videos is, most of the times it's a lot of fun for me, you know. I'm very excited with the Attica now, like...
If I'm not mistaken, you also made a film promoting Crete as a filming location destination.
Yeah.
Can you tell me a little bit how is this working, or are you still involved in this, or were you just doing the film?
Yeah, we're very involved in as representatives, my company, in making Crete one of the destinations for having film crews around the world and filming in Greece, and for the past year. Here we have in Greece, they've voted, the government has voted a tax incentive program for foreign productions to come and film in Greece. So the prefecture of Crete is actually bonding on us right now to actually come in touch with production companies and producers all around the world to come and film in Crete, because obviously you understand that this is one of the best ways to advertise your island. In spring, there's a feature film going to be filmed in Greece, and we are setting this up. We are line producing this project, and the protagonist of this film is Emma Stone, Oscar winner Emma Stone, and it's a British production, and they are filming in spring, and my company is accommodating this production. So we're also very involved in filming, in actually accommodating productions from the rest of the world to film in Crete. Crete is an incredible island. You know, right now, all the mountains, it has a big, a lot of mountains around in the middle of the island, and the island is really huge. And so you have scenery that looks like the Alps, and then you have beaches, and about 2 months from now you can be swimming in the sea whilst you're looking at the snowy mountains. So it's a very rich island in terms of locations. So we're trying to promote this, and I've actually made a video that done this, and it has also been awarded at the festivals over here. I actually had this, but I think I've exceeded my half an hour.
Okay, thank you.
Hey? Have we got some time? Okay.
5-6 minutes.
Okay.
And I think it's a good story.
Yeah, it was done ages ago. One of the reasons it was made is that we approached, and this was like, I think, 8 years ago, and we approached the prefecture and said, listen, you know, we have to start, you know, developing the idea that film sets should come and film in Crete. And they were like, yeah, this sounds like a good idea. And they said, okay, let's make a film about it. So we made this film, but they didn't really invest in this because, you know, you have to invest properly into doing something like this. So they started using this as a tourist campaign. So we made it primarily so this could reach producers around the world. But the prefecture used it as a tourist campaign. And they, I don't know, they promoted it. Not so much.
Well, I remember the film very well because I've seen the film several times later, but with different destinations. So
really?
So therefore, yeah. So you got inspired by other films, so people got inspired by your film as well. Okay. So that's cool.
Okay, that's a fair deal.
Good evening, Mr. Santino.
You're late.
I'm terribly sorry, but your airport was busy.
Airports tend to be like that.
This is the movie the entire world will remember you for. Your next number one box office hit.
Beware Greeks bearing gifts.
If you act clever, this is going to be your cheapest movie and your best movie.
So, what is this big idea?
Around the world in 80 days. Modern, cosmopolitan version of this man's classic novel. Do you figure?
No, I don't. Besides, it's already been done.
Listen to me. This is a totally new approach. A modern Phileas Fogg makes a bet not with some British aristocrats, but with a mystery lady. She is following him around the world to make sure that he fails because she wants his money.
And what about my money? What I want are low-budget movies. That's all there is to it. Oh, heavens above. Not again.
Our story starts here. Amazon. Jungle. An apparently dead body of a man floats down a river. The river is about to send body over a high waterfall, close up to his face. It's Phileas Fogg.
The story starts in London.
Please let me finish. The movie is a journey through time. Flashbacks will finally lead us to London. Our two protagonists will be in the same places but won't know each other until... Thailand. A beautiful woman, type Anne Hathaway, runs panic-stricken on an empty beach. She's naked? An unconcerned Phileas sits on a hill that overlooks the bay. Next stop, Nepal. Swarm of eagles fly past.
Eagles don't swarm. Bees swarm. Use bees, they're cheaper.
Anne pulls out a knife and stabs him.
You're going to kill your leading man so soon?
Venice. A man is walking past a misty alley and stops in front of a wooden door. It's Phileas Fogg. He's alive. Finally escape by crossing.
He's alive. And regretted. She realized she's in love with him and saved him
from bleeding to death.
The fire does great.
She tells him the truth. His brother has sacrificed him, running with a chip into a vast desert. And now Phileas Fogg searches for him on the streets of fair places, but won't know each other until... High-speed jet zooms across the frame. Shortly before it hits the mountain, a parachute opens. They look each other in the eyes. Their bodies are close. Their lips almost touch. Someday.
Interesting, but expensive. Far too expensive. A movie around the world, actors, travel, hotels.
Look. We will shoot the entire thing here.
What's that?
Crete. That's Crete. The most beautiful island in the Mediterranean. Because all those places I mentioned, and a whole lot more. You drive from one end of the island to the other within 4 hours, and still you think that you've just been around the world.
And what is this?
your ticket to the world of Crete to see for yourself.
Morning that I woke up to go filming, I just had this idea about this guy pulling out of his case Barbie, and then I said, fuck, I need a John John. And then I called my art director, the British guy that played in that other commercial. I said, man, have you got a Barbie? And he said, what do you want the Barbie for? I just had this idea of, you know, Nikos just pulling out the Barbie out of his suitcase. But I needed John John. So it was a Sunday morning, and I remember Douglas driving all over the city to find a John John. So he found a John John and a Barbie. And that morning, actually, we went and we started improvising with the Barbie and the John John. And that came as an element into the film, the first shoot. And then I remember going to all the locations around Crete with the Barbie and the John John. And then the tourists, I remember the tourists checking us out, like a whole film crew of about 10 people, and I was holding a Barbie and a John John on the beach. And these tourists were just wondering, what the fuck are those filmmakers doing filming a Barbie and a John John on the beach? Making love, kissing each other. So that was one of the funny highlights of this production. Thank you very much. Thank you.